I have to say this right out of the blue, because I talked to a number of people so far on this podcast, and majority of them are in film. And what's striking about yourself is you fully embrace writing, something a lot of people don't even have the courage to look at the blank page. They openly admit it because, again, like I said, it takes a lot of courage to do so.
Yeah.
What is so I highly commend you on that, because yes, I have to say it's very admirable. But what is it about writing that you chose out of all the roles in filmmaking that writing is your thing?
I mean, you know, I think it speaks for, I think it worked differently for a lot of different people. For me, it was definitely partly, in large part, because I was really introverted quite young. I grew up in Montreal, which in of itself, if you're an Anglo in a Franco area, you're already kind of on an island, so to speak. And then if you're an Anglo and you're brown in an area that's predominantly Franco and not
There's
so
a lot
much
of things working against you.
Yeah. So I was kind of put in a situation early on where I was an observer. And you know, inherently you become a student of human character, psychology, the mechanisms of kind of human interaction and the ecology of, you know, small sample sizes society, right?
Mm-hmm.
And within that, so once you kind of are forced to sit back and observe, as opposed to being, because when you're in it and you're partaking fully, I feel like you're kind of not probably given the bandwidth to be able to soak in everything that's happening, especially on a more granular level. That wasn't a problem for me, Daniel, because you know, based on where I was at, like I observed kind of everything from everybody's story, you know, not just my own. I didn't have the luxury of being preoccupied with my own story, which was really good. It worked out really well because I could gain an appreciation for everybody else's, you know what I mean? And once you do that, you kind of start to see the pieces or the connections between pieces, between people, between situations that bleed into people and people that bleed into situations, and the emphasis that one can have on the other. And I feel like that gave me the ability or the appreciation for storytelling. And I think as a writer, and I'm sure you can relate as well. I mean, you've got a writing background, and even as with your directing background as well, mm-hmm. you're still kind of in the gig of storytelling, right? And as a writer, primarily, you've got an appreciation for stories and the telling of the stories and the integrity and the authenticity of the story from the standpoint of like, okay, well, does this character belong in this situation? Does it make sense? Is it authentic that this character would react in this way? And it's funny, and I'd love to hear your thoughts about it too, but like, don't you find that often a good story idea can come from like the most randomest of things?
Yeah, a great story does come from literally the most random, you know, acts of inspiration, sometimes when you least expect it. I guess the cliche thing is when you're in a shower. That's actually happened to me multiple times. Yeah, like when an idea will strike. I think there's something therapeutic about the water hitting your back or something, that you just, like, maybe the creative juices are flowing a different way. But yeah, with regards to storytelling, I think, like you said, with regards to writing or directing, the best stories are the best form of inspiration I've identified in my works, where it comes from my past. It comes from a place where I want to tell my stories. And, mm-hmm. you know, the stories that we've created, even the one that we collaborated with last called Cracked, written with you and Kosa, that story, what I explained to you and him is I was going through some mental illness, some kind of low part of my life, and I wanted to apply it as best as I could, express it through my role as the director, as the cinematographer, and ultimately the editor. Mm-hmm. And that's where what I'm saying is, regards to storytelling, the best stories, this is why, again, Tarantino, this is why I love Scorsese, is they use the experiences in their past to make this best story possible, to make it most authentic, as you were saying.
Authentic, yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. The word authentic is what's very key. And that's why you and I have collaborated and plan to collaborate more because we value that word authenticity, to not compromise, you know, just for the sake of compromising or for the sake of appealing 100%. To just a niche market. We compromise only if it's going to make sense. It's always for the sake of the story, right?
Yeah.
So that's very important. What actually, you said. And if, go ahead.
And if I could kind of carry that thought, just like another one step forward is when you're in that situation as a writer and you're working with a director and a cinematographer and an editor, you wore a lot of hats on that one, Daniel.
Yeah, no, I did. I did. Yeah. I was a caterer too. I brought paninis.
You know what? I don't know. I don't know if I'm going to give you the best marks on that one.
But, yeah, I know. Right. I got food. Danny's like, I got food poisoning.
Yeah, no, that was a weak part, man. I wouldn't put that on the resume. Just
like that joke I made from the caterers of Cracked. That's going to be my credit on the next project.
No, absolutely. Absolutely. Just on, you know, I don't know if you're going to get the best of reviews necessarily. Like if anyone calls me for a reference, Daniel, I'm going to have to be honest. But no, like, As a writer, when you're working with a director and an editor, you know what, the whole cast that we worked with on Cracked, I mean, the outside of the work and outside of the talent that everybody kind of brought forward, the authenticity that kind of everyone lended towards, and you can kind of see it in the final product, is that it's just that much better for it, you know? And but you can't come up with that if you don't have the proper story, you know, and to circle back to like to your question, it's, I think, a major part of why people feel a little bit of a little bit of weight, you know, when they take on telling a story, because the authenticity is something I feel most people, if not all, inherently feel an obligation for, you know. Whether or not it's executed is a completely different matter, which, you know, we'll touch on that, I'm sure, later, as far as the technical demands of screenwriting is a story in of itself.